Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. In this video, I will share some common electrical problems related to cargo crane. First is emergency stop. It can be operated in case of any emergency. Once emergency stop is energized, then it will interrupt the power supply and main switch will be off. According to diagram, all emergency stop switches are connected in series and keeping Q01 and K03 energized always. Q01 is main switch. If any of this emergency switch is open, then it will de-energize coil Q1 and trip main circuit breaker. So before you reset main circuit breaker, make sure you release all the emergency stop switches. Number 2. Overcurrent protection. It is provided in case of overloading condition of motor. Also, you can see motor fault indication on the panel. Reset the relay, start the motor again, and keep an eye on ampere reading of the motor for next few minutes. Number 3 is hydraulic oil level low. In this case, electrical motor will trip. If low oil level is detected by level switch, then it will de-energize K32 and trigger off delay timer. Once set time is over, contact of K32 will be open and K09 will be de-energized. And motor will stop because K09 is auxiliary coil for motor. You can also check oil level or level indicator. Just by pressing on button, you can restart the motor. Number 4 is PTC protection, which is motor overheat protection. In this case also, it will show motor fault indication. Either overcurrent or PTC protection is activated, it will give motor fault indication. In case of overloading or overheating because of insufficient cooling inside the cabin, PTC protection will be activated and motor will trip. This is the reset button for PTC protection. Number 5 is limit switch. These are limit switches for sleeving operation. If you want to know the location of luffing and hoisting limit switches, then please do watch previous video, Cargo Crane Tour. So limit switches are meant for safe operation of crane. Please do not bypass any limit switch because it is not safe and it can lead to major accidents. Sometimes limit switch gets activated in the middle of cargo operation. I will show you where to check limit switch. Let's consider a scenario. There is a problem with luffing up operation, means boom cannot be lifted up. According to diagram, K19 contactor must be always energized for luffing up operation. If it is de-energized, then check condition of limit switch 4ES03. We have to check continuity at terminal block X1 between terminals 1 and 149. On top of crane at machinery deck, there is electrical cabinet, and inside cabinet you can find these terminal blocks. This is terminal 1 and 149. Here you can check continuity with multimeter. Let's consider one more example, problem in lowering boom. As per diagram, K18 must be energized to lower the boom. If it is de-energized, then check limit switch 4ES02. We have to make sure there is continuity between terminal 1 and 145. So these are terminals 1 and 145. You can check continuity with multimeter. I hope you guys understood where to check limit switches inside the electrical cabinet only. But I will remind one more time, do not bypass any limit switch. Out of 5 problems, at least one of them you will face on cargo crane. So hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to like and share with your friends. Thank you for watching Lady ETO on board.